Good day, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen across the world. It is my pleasure and a real privilege to present this seminar. My appreciation goes to the organizer, the International Affairs Session of the Society of American Archivists. I'm also particularly grateful to Dr. James Laurie, Assistant Professor at Graduate School of Library and Information Studies, Queens College of the City University of New York, who is my colleague, friend, and partner of many years for nominating me for the seminar. When Dr. Laurie contacted me and sought to know if I would be willing to present the seminar on Nigeria, I did not hesitate to jump at the opportunity to talk to colleagues around the world on archival landscapes in Nigeria. My gratitude also goes to Queens College, City University of New York, for providing the enabling environment for this seminar. My presentation will focus on background information about Nigeria, evolution of National Archives of Nigeria, archival legislations, archive building, other archival institutions in Nigeria, legal framework, and the role of National Archives, staffing profile, education and training, professional association, challenges, and finally, conclusion. First, let me talk about Nigeria. Nigeria is an African country on the Gulf of Guinea in West Africa. Nigeria is reputed to be the most populous country in Africa. The population is over 200 million. The country comprises 36 states and federal capital territory, grouped into six geopolitical zones, which are Southwest, Southeast, South-South, Northwest, Northeast, and North Central. Nigeria is a former British colony, and it attained independence in 1960. It attained Republican status in 1963, and from 1966 to 1979, there was the military intervention. Again, from the last day of December 1983 to 1999, there was also military intervention. Nigeria has, however, been a stable democracy since 1999. The country's currency is Naira, which replaced Nigerian pound in 1973, which, of course, was a vestige of colonialism. Evolution of archives in Nigeria. Nigeria emerged as a political entity with the amalgamation of Northern and Southern Protectorates on 1st January 1914. Deep concern was expressed the same year, that is in 1914, in a dispatch by Colonial Office about the custody and preservation of older official records of government. The dispatch of 1914 specifically requested for a brief report as to the existing arrangements for the custody and preservation of the records. Sir Frederick Lugard, who was the Governor General at the time, in his reply to the dispatch of 1914, concluded that the records of the colonial administration were in a fair state of preservation. In other words, Lugard expressed the opinion that the records of government were well preserved. Other dispatches were also sent to the colony in 1936 and 1948 on the same subject matter. The dispatch of 1936 specifically advised that appraisal of records should be adequately supervised by a responsible authority to avoid the incidents of destruction of records of actual or potential historical value. The 1948 dispatch also emphasized the necessity of preserving records, particularly those of historical interest. Concerns were also expressed by individuals like Sir Hilary Jenkinson, the celebrated English archivist and the then Deputy Keeper of Public Records in London, who particularly made an offer of technical assistance. In a memorandum, Jenkinson underscored the need for a survey of the records preservation situation in all colonial territories, citing the examples of the attention which archives management was receiving in Europe and America. Sensitization and expressions of concern, however, failed due to lack of budgetary provision and enthusiasm on the part of British officials in Nigeria. Dike's intervention is another phase in the evolution of archives in Nigeria. Kenneth Onwuka Dike played a vital role in the process. Dike was a researcher and scholar in the discipline of history. He became the first indigenous principal of University College and Vice Chancellor, University of Ibadan. Dike expressed concern about the state of government official records, just as earlier commentators on the issues had also expressed concern about the need to ensure that records of government were properly preserved. In any case, or in fact, Dike came across records in deplorable state in the course of his research. In 1950, he submitted a proposal to the colonial government to carry out free of charge a preliminary survey of government records and other archives in Nigeria. The proposal was accepted. He carried out the assignments, and the final report was submitted in September 1953. One of the recommendations made and accepted was the establishment of the Nigerian Record Office. The nomenclature was also fashioned after the Public Record Office in London. The Nigerian Record Office was established on 1st April 1954. It was located in the campus of University College Ibadan, as the University of Ibadan then was. The enabling legislation, the Public Archives Ordinance, was enacted in 1957 with the commencement date of 14th November 1954. Now, a brief look at archive legislations in Nigeria. The first archival legislation was the Public Archives Ordinance, which formally established the National Archives of Nigeria. The ordinance focused mainly on the management of non-current records of the central government. The term archives was defined in the ordinance to exclude the public records of regional governments. The ordinance granted the Director of National Archives the power to examine and give advice on the care, custody, and control of records in public offices. The ordinance, however, has been criticized as being inadequate to address the problem of archives administration and records management in Nigeria. However, the National Archives had to operate within the framework of the legislation, that is the ordinance, until 1992, when the National Archives Act was enacted to replace and repeal the Public Archives Ordinance. The National Archives Act at the time of promulgation was known as the National Archives Decree. This was because it was an enactment by a military administration. The law is now incorporated in the laws of the Federation Federation of Nigeria 2004 as the National Archives Act Cap N6. Later, I will consider some of the provisions of the Act. Now, let me talk briefly about archive building in Nigeria. The first archive building of the National Archives was purposely built and opened in 1958 on the campus of University of Ibadan. Between 1958 and 1963, other archival buildings were erected in Kaduna and Enugu, which were then the branch offices of the National Archives of Nigeria. These two offices were later upgraded to the status of SONA offices, as they are today. Ibadan remained the headquarters until the movement to Lagos and finally to Abuja. Today, there are four branches of National Archives spread across the country, most of which are located in rented accommodation or federal secretariats, while the headquarters is in Abuja, the Federal Capital Territory. Arrangement of archives in the repositories of the National Archives is based on the principle of provenance and the principle of original order. Repositories are grouped into federal, states, and special to reflect the ownership or nature of the archives housed in the repositories. Archival description is undertaken through the preparation of finding aids. Available finding aids include sample lists, class or special lists, inventory, index, and guide. A key published finding aid is Guide to Sources of Nigerian History, which highlights the holdings of the three main repositories of the National Archives in Ibadan, Kaduna, and Enugu in the first volume. The finding aid was planned to be published in volume, the first volume dealing with records in the National Archives of Ibadan, Kaduna, and Enugu. The publication was also a product of the resolution of West African Regional Branch of the International Council on Archives, WABICA, to prepare a general guide to sources of West African history. Subsequent volumes were planned to take care of the holdings of other archival repositories, including private records. The subsequent volumes, to the best of my knowledge, were never published, thus leaving a huge gap. Some of the findings in the National Archives are due for review, as some of the records they relate to have been lost to deterioration. Some of the archives in the National Archives have been digitized, but are yet to have web presence due to absence of a policy framework. Other archival institutions also emerged in Nigeria. This is because archival matters are in the concurrent legislative list of the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, 1999, as amended. So to this extent, a House of Assembly of a state may make law for the state with respect to archives and public records of the government of the state. In exercise of this power, Lagos State, for instance, enacted a law, the Lagos State Records and Archives Law, with the commencement date of 18th May 2007, to establish the Lagos State Records and Archives Bureau. A few other states, even without an enabling legislation, also established their own state archives. Examples of these are Edo, Delta, and Federal Capital Territory. Some of the states, particularly those in the northern part of Nigeria, also established archival repositories, which of course we are not known by the nomenclature of archives. They are called history bureau. Some universities, such as University of Ibadan, University of Ilorin, and University of Maiduguri, have also established university archives. Some corporate bodies in the oil and banking sectors also have archival repositories. There are also corporate organizations established to render custodial archival services. A legal framework and the role of national archives. The National Archives Act is the main legal framework for archives, administration, and records management in Nigeria. The Act grants the Director of National Archives the power to examine public records in the custody of a public office. The Director also bears the responsibility for the establishment of Federal Records Center for the management of non-current public records as an integral part of the National Archives. The Director, with the approval of the Minister, that is the supervising minister, is to issue general schedules for the retention and disposal of records common to several or all public offices. These are records of common categories. The Act also stipulates 25 years access rule to public archives. Archives of lesser age may also be made available for public inspection, provided no interest will be jeopardized. Private archives relating to private life of individuals are not to be open for inspection of members of the public, except with the written permission of the persons concerned, their heirs, or executors. This provision is made to really safeguard the privacy of individuals. Access to archives voluntarily deposited by a private body or individual is regulated by the conditions agreed between the depositor and the director. So invariably there could be donor-imposed conditions of access, which the archival institution must comply with. The director also has the discretion to refuse access to any archives on the ground of their fragile conditions. I may even deny access to any archives which are not yet processed by way of a classification or repaired or given any other treatments that may be required. The Director of National Archives is also granted the power to inspect, survey, and advise on the safe custody, preservation, and care of all non-current records and historical documents held by private bodies and individuals in Nigeria. The Act makes provision for transfer of non-current records of the age of 25 years and above, meriting preservation to the National Archives. though the provision of the law says 25 years or more. However, records of lesser age can also be transferred depending on the situation, particularly if they are in danger of, you know, deterioration or loss. And if the public office concerned has failed to do the needful by taking necessary steps to ensure proper preservation of such records. There is also provision made for statutory delivery of two copies of every publication issued by every public office for preservation as printed archives in the National Archives. So every public office is under an obligation to deposit two copies of its publication in the National Archives. Provision is also made for preservation by the National Archives of constitutional and legal documents of the federal government. This role the National Archives has discharged effectively since its inception, in that if you go to the National Archives of Nigeria, you come across various constitutional documents, constitutional or legal documents. For instance, the various treaties made between the British officials and the local rulers during the incursion of the British into the territory now known as Nigeria, and before the establishment of the colonial rule in, you know, in Nigeria. Provision is also made for repatriation to Nigeria of public records or records of historical value exported from Nigeria before the commencement of the act. And this is talking about displaced archives, which of course has been an issue, you know, subject of debate for quite some time. My good friend James has worked extensively on displaced archives. The National Archives Act also gives the state governments the right and power to establish its own archives. That is, a state government in Nigeria is at liberty under the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to establish its own archives. This stems from the fact that archival matters, just as I said earlier, are matters in the concurrent legislative list. A state which is not disposed to establishing its own archives is at liberty to transfer the management of such archives to the National Archives. The implication of such transfer, according to the Act, however, is that such records will be managed as federal archives. Two or more states can also come together to establish a joint archives. For instance, we have some states in Nigeria that really share, common culture, common, you know, administration, because some of these new states were created from the old. So the possibility of having records relating, cutting across these states cannot be ruled out. So such states is given the power to come together to establish joint archival repositories. Business houses or companies are also required to operate archives division on attaining the 25th year of operation. A business house which has not really attained that age can establish an archival division if it so wishes. A business house is also at liberty to team up with another business house to establish joint archives division. However, this may not be an option that should, you know, be exploited by business house, particularly those who are in competitors in business, so that trade secrets of one business house may not be known or be made available to the other business house. Business houses of lesser age, just as I have said, can establish its own archives division. However, a business house that fails to comply with this provision, we have its records compulsorily transferred to the National Archives, and this will be without compensation. Records so transferred are also deemed and managed as public records. The Act also prohibits willful damage or destruction of archives in the National Archives of Nigeria. So it is an offense to willfully damage or destroy archives. Staffing profile. Now let me talk a bit about the staffing profile of archives in Nigeria, particularly the National Archives. In the past, the National Archives had a crop of well-trained and experienced archivists, conservators, and other technical staff. Most of the staff had their professional training abroad, some in the UK, with a period of attachment at the Public Record Office, now the National Archives of the UK, some in Canada, some in India, while others attended the UNESCO Regional Training Center for English-speaking West African countries, then located in Ghana. The standard of practice then was high. Nigerian archivists served in and assisted other African countries like Lesotho and the Gambia to build up their archival institutions. The number of staff of the National Archives rose steadily in the first three decades of its existence and also declined steadily in the last two decades. For instance, the staff strength as at May 1989 was 585, while it decreased to 214 in February 2017. Despite the expansion program of the 1980s and early 1990s, which led to increase in the number of offices across the country. Professionalism has also nosedived due to the spate of retirement of experienced archivists without commensurate replacements and training. In the past, reliance was placed on foreign institutions and centers for the training of archivists. The institutions and centers, as indicated earlier, include Public Record Office, now the National Archives, Bundu Shashif in Germany, the then National Archives of Canada, National Archives of India, and UNESCO Regional Center in Ghana for the English-speaking West African countries. Today, archivists are trained in local institutions. University of Ibadan is the leading institution for the education and training of archivists and records managers in Nigeria. At Ibadan, archival academic programs are run at the master and doctoral levels. The National Archives remains the archival institution for practical experience particularly for students of Akaiba academic programs of University of Ibadan on industrial training. Other institutions that run academic programs at various levels in archives and records management include Bayero University, Kano, University of Uyo, Rivers State University, Port Harcourt, Bangkok University, Elisha, and Adeleke University, Ede. The last two institutions are private universities in Nigeria. Professional Association. The Society of Nigerian Archivists is the foremost professional association in archives administration in Nigeria. The society was formed in 1983 in Jos, Nigeria, during the meeting of the West African Regional Branch of the International Council on Archives. The society was registered in 1993 under the Incorporation of Trustees Part of the Companies and Allied Matters Act of Nigeria. The society, in the first two decades of its existence, was well organized and a benchmark for other professional associations in Nigeria. Its members, then mostly drawn from the National Archives, were active participants in the activities of the West African Regional Branch of the International Council on Archives, as well as the International Council on Archives. Some of them held positions in committees of the International Council on Archives. In 1994, the Pan-African Conference on Archival Policies and Programs was held in Abuja, Nigeria. During the conference, the Society of African Archivists was inaugurated. The Society of Nigerian Archivists was given the mandate to nurture the new professional body for Africa, simply because of the success story of the Society of Nigerian Archivists. The Society published a peer-reviewed journal called The Nigerian Archives. Challenges. There are many challenges facing archives administration in Nigeria. The major challenge is poor funding for archives at almost all the levels of archival establishments, whether in the federal, states, or even at private sector level, you discover that the funding for archives is nothing to really talk about, as the money usually appropriated for archives management are not is not anything substantial that can take care of the archival program of any archival establishment. There is also the problem of outdated or weak archival legislation. As we know, legislation or law is dynamic, and it's expected to be reviewed from time to time to take care of the changing circumstances. The National Archives Act, just as I said earlier, was enacted in 1992. Since that time, a lot could be said to have happened in the archives arena. For instance, there have been many changes. The issue of management of electronic records is an issue which is not taken care of in the National Archives Act. there is also the issue of autonomy, which one would expect that the archival legislation should be reviewed to take care of, which then leads me to another major problem, which is the absence of autonomy for national archives and other public archival institutions in Nigeria. These archival institutions are under ministries, and they constitute department of ministries. For instance, the National Archives is now under the Ministry of Information and Culture, that is Federal Ministry of Information and Culture. In fact, the National Archives actually has a kind of checkered history when it comes to movement from one ministry to another. I remember that at a point, the National Archives was under the Ministry of Works. So you can imagine. So at a point, it was under the Ministry of Education. So there is no stability in the placement of National Archives until probably recently, or in the last 10 years, when it has been under the Federal Ministry of Information and Culture. But what matters is the status of the archival institution. As a department in the ministry, there is really not much that can be done in terms of attracting budgetary provision to the institution. For instance, when money is allocated to the ministry, before it trickles down to the various departments under the ministry, the money would have really thinned down. One would expect that the National Archives, as it is in most other countries, should have autonomous status. Or the option, assuming it's not fully autonomous, the option of being in the presidency, or in the case of states, maybe under the governor's office, where one would expect better care would have been, would have been what they, should focus on. But as it is, funding is, always gradually dwindling. And this is as a result of the status of the National Archives as a department in the ministry. There is also the problem of poor staffing. I've mentioned earlier that in the last 2 or 3 decades, things have not been too good in terms of, the staffing of the National Archives in particular, due to spate of retirement of experienced archivists without replacement or succession plan. There is even also the problem of low morale on the part of staff working in the National Archives. Some of them are not excited at being there because of the problem of facilities, and in some cases, absence of an encouraging or attractive career path for them. There is also the problem of outdated and deteriorated facilities and equipment. The most of the facilities and equipment were put in place a long time ago. In fact, during the golden age of the National Archives. So these facilities for quite some time have not been replaced, including equipment. And as such, they are not adequate to meet the present needs of the institution. Some of the equipment too, they are so outdated that to get them repaired when they break down is a problem, because their spare parts are no longer even available. there is also the problem of low priority for archives, particularly in the public sector. So when it comes to, you know, the scale of priority, either for government or even in private sector, for management, you discover that archival matters are rated very low. So the question is, what are they doing? Whereas when it comes to, you know, records, they are so important that they constitute the memory of an organization, just as they also constitute the memory of a nation. Archives administration, in conclusion, in Nigeria has come a long way. The first three decades of the existence of national archives, and by implication, archives administration in Nigeria witnessed a steady rise in the fortune and profile of archival profession in Nigeria. The practitioners there were in touch and in tune with development and best practice in the archival world. On the contrary, the last two decades has witnessed a steady decline. The present image of archives in Nigeria looks worrisome and requires a wake-up call to revive the golden age of archives administration in Nigeria. Once again, I want to express my gratitude to the organizer of this program for this opportunity, the rare opportunity to make this presentation. I also thank you immensely, my good audience across the world. So thank you very much for listening.